What's up, amigos? We continue with the epic infinite logo fly-through animation, focusing on converting the vector logos into shape layers and animating the logos. Let's import the Illustrator file that we just created and hit import. And we'll select composition. And for the dimensions, it doesn't really matter in this case. So you can select either layer or document size. Hit OK. Now let's jump into this comp. Hit Control K, Command K to go to the comp settings. And notice that the width and the height is exactly the same that we selected in Illustrator. Now for the frame rate, simply select your frame rate. For this example, I'll leave it at 23976. And for the background color, I'll simply change it to dark gray since most of the logos are black. Now let's make a copy of this comp, Control D, Command D. And this one, let's call it Nike Animation. Double click to jump into this composition and select all the layers that do not pertain to the Nike logo, just leaving the Nike logo by itself. Now, you can go ahead and animate these vector layers, or you can convert it into a shape layer. Now, I prefer to convert it to shape layers because it gives me more flexibility. I have all the properties that comes with a shape layer. So let me show you how to do that. Let's go up to layer, create shapes from vector layer, and we can go ahead and delete the old vector layers. And let's just simply rename this to Nike, and this one is Swoosh. Now for Nike, let's split it up into each individual letters. So what we'll do is we'll make a couple copies, three copies. And the first one, let's solo it. Let's drill down since it's a shape layer. What we can do is we can modify these. So you have group one, group two is K and E. We can delete that, and group one is the letter N and I. Let's drill further, let's drill down. We have path one and path two. So you can see that path two is for the letter N and path one is for the letter I. So let's go ahead and delete path one. Merge path, we don't need that. We can delete it, and this one will be for the letter N. Now we'll repeat the same process for the letter I. This one should be easier since we know that it is path one. So we can select two, path two, and merge path and delete it. And we'll go to Nike three. This one will be for K and this one will be for the letter E. Let's solo this, drill down. Now this one is a little tricky, because path one is simply this little shape, this triangle shape that you see here. If we delete it, all it really was doing was creating this empty space. It was subtracting with the merge path. So what we'll do is, let's go in. We're going to have to adjust this manually. So what we'll do is, let's create some guides. Let's go ahead and delete path one and the merge path. And let's go up here and select the delete vertex tool. And let's go ahead and delete these points. Now let's go to our selection tool. Let's bring these points over. This one will go up here. And this one over here. Perfect. Let's go to E. And delete some points. And what we'll do is select these two. Let's move them over. Perfect. The next step is to animate the logo. Let's animate this Nike logo. Let's start with a swoosh. We'll go to effect and let's go to transition. For the NFL logo animation, I use a lot of these effects, especially the grid wipe, the CC line sweep. I use the linear wipe and Venetian blinds and the radial wipe. So a lot of these were my go-tos. Let's start with a CC line sweep. We'll change the direction to 90 and we'll animate it We'll animate the completion. So let's make it 100%. Make sure that your CTI is at the beginning. Click on the stopwatch to add a keyframe. Hit U on the keyboard so you can see the keyframe on the timeline. And let's go to frame 12 and make this 0. That's it. Let's select the keyframes, F9 for easy ease. And what we can do is jump into the valley graph, select the first keyframe. Let's move this handle down. We want it to start very fast and then slow down at the end. Let's check it out. Okay, perfect. Now let's go to the letter N and go back to effect. And for this one, select linear wipe. And for the angle, we'll make it 180. And for completion, let's see, we're going to start at 55%. Move your CTI to the beginning. Let's add a keyframe. Hit U so we can see that keyframe on the timeline. And let's move the CTI to frame 7. And let's adjust the completion. Let's make it, let's see, right at 15. Nope, let's make it 10%. Perfect. And then let's add easy ease, F9. Let's jump into the valley graph. Make sure that you are in the valley graph. Again, let's give it a quick start and let's slow it down at the end. Perfect. Now what we can do is we can copy this effect and apply it to the rest of the letters. So select the effect, Control C, Command C, and let's paste it, Control V, Command V, hit U so you can confirm that it pasted the effect. And now what you can do is we can stagger these layers. So what we'll do is every 2 frames. And then let's slide it over and let's check it out. Perfect. Very simple animation, but it is effective. Now you're going to repeat this process. Use your creativity and your imagination to animate the rest of your logos. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what I did for the Puma, the Vans, and the Adidas. Let's go ahead and check out the different animations for the other brands. That's Adidas, this is Puma, and this is Vans. And you can see it's really simple. Vans is simply an animation for the position. Same thing with Puma, just animating the position. And Adidas is a little more complex, but you'll see once you put it, composite all the different layers together, it'll be effective. Now, one thing that we need to do across the board for all the different logo animation is we need to create that layer that we'll use as our cutout or the mat. And that will be the outermost layer for our logo. In this case, the skateboard. So let's go to the skateboard. Let's make a copy of this layer, Control D, Command D, rename it to Vans Mat. Let's solo this layer. And if we toggle the transparency grid, we need to do some modifications. We need to get rid of all the text and the wheel and this line. So let's go ahead and drill down. Since it's a shape layer, it doesn't matter. That's one of the advantages of converting it into shape layer. You can make these modifications here in After Effects. So let's go all the way down. There are 24 different paths. The first 23 we can delete. And there you go. This will be our cutout that we'll use to cut it out. And once you're done, you can simply, what I like to do is just hide it. We don't need it in this Vans animation comp. We're going to just copy and paste it into our animation comp, which we'll do in the next step. So repeat this process for the other ones. Puma is pretty simple. It's simply a copy of this layer, the Puma layer, the Adidas ones as well, and the Nike one too.